The Senate will come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise and recite the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. In the absence of clergy, let us bow our heads in a moment of silent reflection or prayer. Reading of the journal.
In Senate, Sunday, May 8, 2022, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The Journal of Saturday, May 7, 2022, was read and approved on motion of Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentation of petitions. Messages from the Assembly. Secretary will read.
Senator Kaplan moves to discharge from the Committee on Transportation Assembly Bill number 3598E and substitute it for the identical Senate Bill 7554, third reading calendar 241.
So ordered.
Senator Borello moves to discharge from the Committee on Finance Assembly Bill number 5338 and substitute it for the identical Senate Bill 1753, third reading calendar 997.
So ordered. Messages from the Governor. Reports of standing committees. Reports of select committees. Communications and reports from state offices. Motions and resolutions. Senator Gennaris.
Mr. President, before I turn to motions, let me just thank my colleagues for their well wishes over the last couple of weeks, and particularly Senators Kennedy and Lou for filling in while I was out of commission. So it is good to be back. And with that, I have many motions for you. Amendments are offered to the following third reading calendar bills by Senator Gorin, calendar 89, Senator Reichland-Melnick, calendar 116, Senator Skoufis, calendar 338, Senator Savino, calendar 542, Senator Harkin, calendar 550, Senator Kaplan, calendar 781, Senator Hoylman, calendar 897, Senator Sanders, calendar 927, Senator Kavanaugh, calendar 1033, Senator Bailey, calendar 599, Senator Cooney, calendar 1067, Senator Ramos, calendar 822, and Senator Addabbo, calendar 906.
Those amendments have all been received, and those bills will retain their place on the third reading calendar. Senator Gennaris.
On behalf of Senator Kaplan, I wish to call up Senate Print 23A, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 123, Senate Print 23A by Senator Kaplan, enactment on the state finance on the labor law.
Consider the vote by which the bill was passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White, aye, 61.
The bill is restored to its place on the third reading calendar.
Long amendments.
The amendments are received and the bill will retain its place in the third reading calendar.
On behalf of Senator Gorin, I wish to call up Senate 7610, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary Reed.
Calendar number 43, Senate Print 7610A by Senator Gorin, an act in relation to permitting India Pentecostal Assembly Incorporated to file an application for real property tax exemption.
Move to reconsider the vote by which the bill is passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White, aye, 61.
The bill is restored to its place in the third reading calendar.
For the following amendments.
The amendments are received and the bill will retain its place in the third reading calendar.
On behalf of Senator Brooks, I wish to call up Senate 7864, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 45, Senate Print 7864 by Senator Brooks, an act to amend the General Municipal Law and the Public Authorities Law.
Move to reconsider the vote by which the bill was passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White, ayes 61.
The bill is restored to its place on the third reading calendar.
The following amendments.
The amendments are received and the bill will retain its place on the third reading calendar.
On behalf of Senator Gorin, I wish to call up Senate 968, recalled from the Assembly, now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 520, Senate Print 968 by Senator Gorin, enactment of the Public Authorities Law.
Consider the vote by which the bill was passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White, ayes 61.
The bill is restored to its place on the third reading calendar.
I offer the following amendments.
The amendments are received and the bill will retain its place on the third reading calendar.
Also from Senator Gorin, I wish to call up Senate 5237B, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 713, Senate Print 5237B by Senator Gorin, enactment of the Public Authorities Law.
Move to reconsider the vote by which the bill is passed.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White, ayes 61.
The bill is restored to its place on the third reading calendar.
I offer the following amendments.
The amendments are received and the bill will retain its place on the third reading calendar.
Please recognize Senator Lanza.
Senator Lanza.
Mr. President, on behalf of Senator Steck, I wish to call up bill print number 5333, recalled from the Assembly, which is now at the desk.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 575, Senate Print 5333 by Senator Steck, concurrent resolution of the Senate and Assembly proposing an amendment to Section 1 of Article 14 of the Constitution.
I now move to reconsider the vote by which this bill was passed.
Call the roll.
Dabo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick, ayes 61.
The bill is restored to its place on the third reading calendar.
Mr. President, I now offer the following amendments.
The amendments are received and the bill will retain its place on the third reading calendar.
Mr. President, on behalf of Senator Weick, on page number 50, I offer the following amendments to calendar number 1016.
Secretary will read. Oh, I'm sorry. The amendments are received and the bill will retain its place. Strike that. The amendments are received and the bill will retain its place in the third reading calendar.
Perfect. Thank you.
Senator Gianaris.
Let's take up the reading of the calendar now.
Secretary will read.
Calendar number 208, Senate print 3178A by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the social services law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect at the 90th day, shall become a law. Calendar number 116, Senate print 3966A by Senator Reich and Melnick, an act to amend the public authorities law and the social services law.
The bill will be laid aside for the day.
Okay. Calendar number 208, Senate print 3178A by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the social services law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act take effect on the 90th day and shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 239, Senate print 3823 by Senator Griffo, an act to amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 241, Assembly number 3593E by Assemblymember Salaj, an act to amend the vehicle and traffic law.
There is a homeroom message at the desk. Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 241, voted in the negative. Senator Skoufis, ayes 60, nays. Also Senator Palumbo. Ayes 59, nays 2.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 254, Senate print 774B by Senator Hoyleman, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect on the 120th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick.
Senator Hoyleman to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. This bill would require the collection of certain demographic information about the sexual orientation and gender identity or expression of residents by state agencies, board, and commissions. And the bill's goal is to keep a more accurate and relevant public record of populations by sexual orientation and gender identity or expression in the state of New York. While gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender, and those of non-conforming gender identity or expression in the state share geographical and cultural commonalities, they also experience diverse social, educational, health, and economic differences that are unique to their life experiences. And given the diversity of the population, separating data for these areas of the population and making the data publicly accessible are critical for enhancing our state's understanding for the needs and experiences of these communities. And while other states are regressing on LGBTQIA rights, New York is moving forward to improve the services and support for all LGBTQIA New Yorkers. The bottom line is, Mr. President, data saves lives, and for decades, the struggle of the LGBTQIA community has been to stop being invisible. And when you don't have data about a community, at times it can seem that that community doesn't exist at all. So with this bill, we are changing that, Mr. President, and I proudly vote aye.
Senator Hoylman to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 254, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Griffo, Helming, Jordan, Lanza, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Ritchie, Stack, Tedisco, and White. Ayes 46, nays 15.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 339, Senate Print 6210A by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend the executive law and the energy law.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar number 339, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Jordan, Lanza, Martucci, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Ritchie, Steck, and Tedisco. Ayes 45, nays 16.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 455, Senate Print 4708 by Senator Comrie, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect on the 1st of January.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 455, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Jordan, Martucci, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Steck, and Tedisco. Ayes 48, nays 13.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 470, Senate Print 6443B by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the Criminal Procedure Law and the Family Court Act.
Read the last section.
Section 7. This act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 470, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Jordan, Lanza, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Rath, Ritchie, Steck, and Tedisco. Ayes 47, nays 14.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 588, Senate Print 1830 by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act should take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 588, voted in the negative, Senator Martucci. Ayes 60, nays 1.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 683, Senate Print 6287B by Senator Mannion, an act to amend the Social Services Law and the Public Health Law.
Read the last section.
Section 6, this act shall take effect on the 180th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 770, Senate print 1232 by Senator Gianaris, an act terminating the environmental conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 770, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Griffo, Jordan, Oberacker, O'Mara, Rath, Steck, and Tedisco. Aye 52, nays 9.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 771, Senate print 2937 by Senator Kaminsky, an act to amend the environmental conservation law.
Lay it aside.
Calendar number 814, Senate print 240B by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the multiple residence law and the multiple dwelling law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect on the 90th day of shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick.
Senator Mayer to explain her vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. And I want to thank the Majority Leader, Senator Stewart Cousins, for bringing this package of bills involving fire to the floor. I can't think of anything more disastrous in so many of our districts than the continued a risk of fire in residential placements. And in January, we all know we witnessed the horrors of the high-rise fire in the Bronx, which killed 17 people, including 8 children. And before and since then, there have been fires in which first responders have had a challenge responding because they do not have a full and accurate list of the occupants of the building. In 2019, in a fire in a Yonkers apartment building in my district, 86 people were displaced. 60 firefighters were on the scene, and there was extensive damage to the building. Fortunately, in large part due to the incredible work of the first responders and the firefighters particularly, no one was injured. But during the blaze, first responders had no way to determine who was still in the building and if everyone was safely evacuated. This bill was a response to this fire and ensures that in a fire or natural disaster requiring evacuation, emergency personnel have access to residents' names and contact information to locate them and confirm they have safely exited the building. This bill grants tenants the right and option to withhold this information if they choose to do so. In an emergency, every second counts, and first responders can most effectively do their jobs and prevent loss of life when they are able to determine the residents they expect to find in the building and know that all residents are safely evacuated. We should not let this day go by without publicly acknowledging the work of our first responders, particularly police and firefighters, who are the first on the scene, the last to leave, put their lives in great personal danger, and are there to protect us during these most dangerous, dangerous of circumstances. Thank you for allowing this bill to come to the floor, and I urge my colleagues to vote aye. I vote aye.
Senator Mayer to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 814, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Jordan, Lanza, Martucci, Matera, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Ritchie, Serino, Steck, and Tedisco. Ayes 44, nays 17.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 819, Senate print 5093A by Senator Kennedy, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 819, voted in the negative, Senator Jordan, ayes 60, nays 1.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 820, Senate print 6089A by Senator Jackson, an act to amend the multiple dwelling law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick.
Senator Jackson to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. My colleagues, I rise to speak in support of my bill. Fire in residential buildings and small businesses has had a devastating impact on our communities. And we have witnessed an uptick in fire emergencies occur in the last 2 years. As our building stock and its infrastructures get older, we have to make sure safety protocols correspond with the realities that more people are using appliances and technology. And today, New York City continues to mourn the victims who lost their lives as a result of fires caused by multiple factors that are a product of landlord and property management not living up to their responsibilities to ensure their properties comply with applicable fire and safety codes. In the very district that I represent, within a year, two terrible fires occurred on the same property in Inwood, resulting in the displacement of dozens of families during the winter. In early 2021, half of this building went up in flames. The cause? Quote unquote, accidental electrical wiring. Over 30 families lost everything. And my office connected them with legal support, which led to a lawsuit against the landlord. However, not even a lawsuit resulting from the fire, from the first fire, was enough to pressure the property owner to do the right thing and inspect the wiring in the entire building. Sadly, a second fire happened in the other half of the building, the cause of the same as the first, faulty electric wiring. We hear every other month the multiple fires are reported in my district and across New York due to the lack of accountability from the owners. These fires were 100% preventable. These fires were not only tragic, but also a clear sign of housing injustice. It would seem evident that apartment buildings and working class communities are often more vulnerable to fires. Flickering lights or the electricity going out if you use a toaster or an AC shouldn't be the clearest situation. It should be caused by alarm that some need to be upgraded or inspected. But this bill is about being proactive and accountable for the safety of the tenants. The history of management neglect, violations, and complaints, including lack of heat and ventilation, make the building in the black and brown community, working class communities, much more susceptible to devastating fires than most of the housing stock in the city. This must end, Mr. President. We cannot continue to lose lives due to the lack of safety measures provided in many New York properties. I vote aye.
Senator Jackson, to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 820, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Jordan, Lanza, Martucci, Matera, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Ritchie, Serino, Steck, and Tedisco. Ayes 43, nays 18.
Bill's passed.
Calendar number 824, Senate Print 8795A by Senator Rivera, an act to amend the executive law and the administrative code of the City of New York.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this action takes effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Rivera to explain his vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. On Sunday, January 19th, of this year, as I'm sure that you are all aware, Twin Parks Northwest, a building just a couple of blocks from my district office in the Bronx, had a terrible fire. Terrible fire, which was worse than one that we've seen in years, certainly in the Bronx. As has been referenced by some of my colleagues, 17 people lost their lives, including 8 children. And the fact is that what caused it, as has also been pointed out by some of my colleagues, the fire in this building, and not only that, but in buildings in other parts of our city, has been at many times negligence and things that could have been fixed. In the case of North Park, of Twin Parks Northwest, it was a series of space heaters in a building, in an apartment that actually caused a fire. And in turn, once the fire started, self-closing doors that were non-operational were left open, therefore spreading the fire to other parts of the building, trapping so many folks in upper buildings, because this only happened on the second floor of this multi-story building. So there's a series of bills that we're passing today, and the one that that is my bill, Mr. President, in particular relates to increasing fines for building and fire code violations. We know that in many instances, and we talk about it constantly, there's certain folks that consider fines, if they're not large enough, they consider it part of doing business. And we want to make sure that we change that as it relates to this. In this case, these penalties and fines were established 30 years ago, Mr. President. And we believe that we need to raise them to make sure that it can serve as a deterrence. It is not the only thing that we are doing, Mr. President. There's a couple of other bills, including one by my colleague, Cordell Clear, who also had a tragic fire in her district, coming up a little bit later, which deals specifically with space heaters. But in this case, I rise to certainly support this piece of legislation, asking my colleagues to do the same. And certainly, Mr. President, while we certainly can't get the lives back that we lost that day, we can do things legislatively to try to force those folks who are, as my colleague Senator Jackson said, sometimes not being responsible with their property and not doing what they should to maintain these property that sometimes lead to deaths. We can make it sure that, at the very least, it costs them, and that we can potentially change the way that they act so that we can save lives in the future. I'll vote in the affirmative. Thank you, Mr. President.
Senator Rivera to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 824, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Boyle, Felder, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Jordan, Martucci, Matera, Oberecker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Ritchie, Serino, Steck, Tedisco, and White. Ayes 41, nays 20.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 997, Assembly number 5338 by Assembly Member Giglio, enactment chapter 264 of the laws of 1981.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 61.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1001, Senate print 3606 by Senator Bailey, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 4, this act shall take effect on the 180th day, it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Tedisco to explain his vote.
Next.
On the next bill. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 1001, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Boyle, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Jordan, Lanza, Martucci, Matera, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Ritchie, Serino, Steck, Tedisco, and White. Ayes 41, nays 20.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1023, Senate print 6761A by Senator Savino, an act to amend the general business law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect on the 180th day and it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Tedisco to explain his vote.
We're in the non-controversial reading of the calendar. It was not laid aside, and so if the Senator would like to explain his vote, he's, of course, welcome to do that.
Thank you, Senator Giannaris. Senator Tedisco.
Thank you. Yeah, my concern about this piece of legislation is falls in line with the goose is as good as the gander, I guess. In Senator Savino's district, the licensing procedure there, I believe I'm correct on this, is the businesses and the construction owner has a license, and all the workers under that construction owner are not necessarily and are not licensed. The construction owner is licensed. What this piece of legislation does, it basically exempts, I believe, Senator Savino's district. It does not apply to Staten Island or New York City, but it does provide for a licensing procedure. But the procedure is not the same as what is taking place in her district. The procedure in this bill says that every single worker for a construction owner and company, if it's 50, if it's 100, if it's 150, fire suppression professionals, all of them have to be licensed. So I'm not quite understanding why there's a different procedure from the sponsor's district of saying construction owner, licensed, all the workers who are professionals in that field don't have to be licensed. But the legislation for upstate, where I'm being contacted by the Upstate American Fire Sprinkler Association with a memo of opposition, every single worker for that construction company and the construction owner has to have all of their individuals go through a process of training and be licensed. So I'm not understanding, if it's a good system in the sponsor's district, why that system wouldn't be a good system for upstate New York. So I'm a bit concerned that it might be more cumbersome for the small businesses and the businesses which relate to this in my upstate district. So in that regard, I'm going to have to vote no on this particular piece. Thank you for the time, Mr. President.
Senator Todisco to be recorded in the negative. Senator Matera to explain his vote.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. I first want to thank Senator Savino for all of her hard work on this bill. As a former member of the Suffolk County Consumers Affairs Licensing Board, Fire Protection and Plumbing for over 10 years, as a proud co-sponsor of this bill, I know how important this legislation is. Fire suppression systems are critical for life and for property safety. In New York City, Nassau, and Suffolk County, contractors who construct this work need to be licensed for fire suppression systems. However, no one needs to be licensed in the rest of the state to perform this work, fire suppression systems. To perform this work, you need to have certain licenses to cut hair, to work at a nail salon to paint nails, to be a librarian, you need to have a license. But you need to be licensed to install fire alarms, but guess what? Not to install the fire suppression system. That's why this is so important, that the men and women installing these systems need to be licensed, installing all the piping and mechanical equipment. An occupation license is needed and required. That they are all qualified and have the same proper knowledge and skill that will protect New York citizens and firefighters from these not having the skills or training to install fire sprinklers. This legislation will make sure that the safety is a priority. Mr. President, I am proud to vote yes. Thank you.
Senator Matera to be recorded in the affirmative. Senator Savino to explain her vote.
Thank you, Mr. President. I want to thank Senator Matera for that excellent explanation of this piece of legislation. As someone who's done the work, he understands how important it is. And I appreciate Senator Todisco's concern. There are differences between New York City and Nassau and Suffolk County and the rest of the state. Namely, this has been in place in New York City and Nassau and Suffolk for quite some time now. And there is another difference with respect to New York City. Under the current law in the city of New York, Nassau and Suffolk, they issue licenses and registration to fire suppression contractors. Under the city code, a person seeking to obtain a license must complete an examination, have requisite experience, and be subject to a background check. The contractors that in these localities, Nassau, Suffolk, and New York City, also oversee the apprenticeship programs for this work. So there is a little bit of a difference in the way they operate in New York City and the way they would operate in the rest of the state. This bill, though, has come before this House before. This is not the first time we're passing it. In fact, it's the same bill that we passed in 2019. We didn't take it up in 2020. And I would point out, Senator Todisco, that you voted for the bill in 2019. Nothing's changed between then and now, except the Assembly has still not taken it up. The issue of fire suppression and fire safety equipment and water-based fire protection systems is critically important. So I understand the concern you have, but what we're doing is we are increasing safety and protection around the rest of the state that we currently have in the city of New York and Nassau and Suffolk County. I vote in the affirmative. Thank you, Mr. President.
Senator Savino will be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 1023, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Helming, Jordan, O'Mara, Rath, Serino, and Todisco. Ayes 54, nays 8.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1024, Senate Print 7863A by Senator Clear, an act to amend the general business law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect on the 120th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick.
Announce the results.
Ayes 62.
The bill is passed. Senator Giannaris, that completes the reading of today's calendar.
Let's move to the controversial calendar, please.
Secretary Reed. Secretary will ring the bell. Secretary Reed.
Calendar number 771, Senate print 2937 by Senator Kaminsky, an act to amend the environmental conservation law.
Senator Lanza, why do you rise?
Mr. President, I believe there's an amendment at the desk. I waive the reading of that amendment and ask that you recognize Senator Weick to be heard.
Thank you, Senator Lanza. Upon review of the amendment in accordance with Rule 6, Section 4B, I rule the non-germane out of order at this time.
Accordingly, Mr. President, I appeal the ruling of the chair and ask that you recognize Senator Weick.
The appeal has been made and heard, and Senator Weick may be heard.
Thank you, Mr. President. This amendment is germane to the bill in chief because both are intended to protect health and safety of our most vulnerable and dangerous of their environment. Right now, we're facing the highest levels of inflation in 40 years, thanks to policies put in place by our federal and state governments. We are paying more for everything from basic necessities like clothes and groceries and food to dining out and travel. In this House, we already took a small step to help consumers by slightly reducing a tax paid at the pump for gasoline. But more than 1 million New Yorkers are facing another surprise in the form of fuel oil prices they will be paying to heat their homes. Now, it's almost 70 degrees out today, and you're wondering, why are we bringing this issue up today? Right now, homeowners across the state are receiving their fuel oil contracts for next winter, and they don't know how they're going to be able to pay for it. This is especially worrisome for Long Islanders in Suffolk County and in Nassau County. I represent Suffolk County, and almost half of the homeowners rely on fuel oil as their primary heat source. In Nassau County, it's about one-third. It's not because they don't have a choice. It's not because they have a choice. Many parts of Long Island are not served by natural gas, and we pay among the highest in electric rates in the nation, so electric heat is not an option either. According to NYSERDA, the average price of heating fuel on Long Island last month was $5.13. That's 62% higher than last year. This is especially acute problem for our seniors and those living on a fixed income. We all know how important it is for these New Yorkers to stay warm and safe, yet our recent budget did nothing to provide additional help for low-income New Yorkers to pay their heating bills. Senator Kaminsky's bill seeks to phase out a type of fuel that's rarely used in home heating outside of New York City. But with this amendment, that bill could have a large impact on homeowners all across this state. We found hundreds of millions of dollars to fund a new football stadium. This amendment to deliver at least some relief to hardworking New Yorkers when they desperately need it, it is so important. I ask that you reconsider your ruling and that my colleagues support this rebate proposal to help families in my region all across the state.
Thank you, Senator Weick. I want to remind the House that the vote is on the procedures of the House and the ruling of the chair. Those in favor of overruling the chair signify by saying aye.
Request a show of hands. Mr. President, we're going to waive the showing of hands and agree to report each member of the minority and the affirmative.
Without objection, so ordered. Announce the results.
Ayes 20.
The ruling of the chair stands, and the bill in chief is before the House. Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, Weick.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 771, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borello, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Jordan, Lanza, Martucci, Matera, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Rath, Ritchie, Serino, Steck, Tedisco, and White. Ayes 44, nays 18.
The bill is passed. Senator Generis, that completes the reading of the controversial calendar.
Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
Move to adjourn until tomorrow, Tuesday, May 10th at 3 p.m.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, May 10th at 3 p.m.